The opinions expressed in the following program are not necessarily those of Eastlink TV, its sponsors, or partners.
Hi, I'm Franco Mariotti, a staff scientist, a biologist here at Science North. And one of the most treasured questions I like to ask visitors to Science North is, name me a whale that is found in Northern Ontario. And once you get over the fact that it's not orcas or killer whales from Marineland, beluga whales make Northern Ontario their home, but so do polar bears. Northern Ontario is home to nearly 1,000 polar bears, and that's what I want to talk about. I want to make a comparison between polar bears, black bears, and grizzly bears, the three bears that are found in North America. All of them are omnivorous, which means that all three bears eat both plants and meat, animals, but polar bears are more meat eaters than the other three. So if we look at these three skulls, for example, here's a black bear. And if you look at the teeth, you can see that the molars back here are flat as canines. So the canines are for grabbing and tearing meat apart, and the flat molars at the back are for grinding vegetation. If we move up to a bigger bear, which is a grizzly, or sometimes called the brown bear, you look at their teeth, very similar. Sharp canines in the front, flat molars at the back. So these animals eat plants and meat. But if you look at the polar bear, their teeth are sharper, not only in the canines, but in the molars also, which means that they're more of a meat eater than any of the other two bears I just talked about. So, and that's because the main food of polar bears across the polar regions, and even in northern Ontario, is seals. That's their main food. So they're a good meat eater. The other neat thing, the difference is, if you look at the claws of these animals, a black bear has small, sharp claws because they tear rotten logs apart and sometimes dig into the earth for ants and things like that and larvae. Grizzly bear, which is a much bigger bear, similar, just a much larger and sharper claw because they tear into the ground a lot. And the polar bear, you would think, is even bigger yet because it's the biggest bear, but it's not. It doesn't need very long claws. It's actually shorter than the grizzly, but it is sharp. And they need that sharpness to grip the ice because that's when they spend most of their lives. For about 8 months of the year, at least, is on the ice going after seals. So the question you may be asking is, how do scientists study polar bears? Where this is the key thing. These are satellite collars. They're placed on a tranquilized bear. And then when the bear wakes up, walks off, scientists can actually track these bears for thousands of kilometers across open ice in James Bay and Hudson's Bay. So what scientists have discovered by following these bears with these satellite collars is that the bears are spending less time on the ice, mainly because of climate change. There's less, the ice appears later and melts earlier, which forces the bears on land much longer than normal. A normal time in the summer would have been 3 months, but now they're spending about 4 months. And so the bears are getting smaller in body mass because they're not getting as much food.
From the day that the doctor said she has cancer and the nurse held my hand and looked at me and said, you're on a new journey now. The day she got her wish, it was like the journey just took a different corner. It's like the light at the end of the tunnel.